Welcome, everybody, to another installment of useful TI-84 programs. This one is called How Long? And particularly, it's with regards to exponential functions like accounts earning interest or population growth that follows an exponential model. Often when we have these problems, we have to use logarithms to solve them, and we get answers that are decimals, and it's kind of tough to check. So I'm going to reiterate this. I feel like I say this for every calculator program video. This is not designed to take the place of authentic pencil and paper work. However, it is designed to be used as something that we can use to check our work very quickly. And also, you know, it might help us in a test environment where we need a decimal answer in a hurry, or we just want to confirm that our work is successful when we have a calculator allowed. So definitely don't do this and think, oh, now I don't have to learn anything. That's not the case at all. We are just going to go through and make a nice little checker for these types of how long problems. Okay, so let's take a look. We'll turn our calculator on. We're going to go to program. And at any point, please feel free to pause this video if you need to catch up with typing stuff into your calculator. I have a nice computer keyboard that I get to use to type things in. So I can type in text quite a bit quicker than you can. But again, feel free to pause the video if you need to catch up or check my coding along the way. When we're in the program menu, we're going to go over to New. We're going to create a new program. Let's hit Enter. And to name this program, I'm going to call it HWLNGEXP. It is possible that we'll be asked to find how long it takes for something to occur in a case that's not exponential, and I don't want to feel like I can use this program in those situations. If we were dealing with a linear function or a quadratic function, something that's not exponential, this would not work at all. So I want to be sure to clearly lay out that when I'm looking for this program, to know that it only works for exponential. That's what the EXP stands for. All right, so that stands for how long for exponential. Let's hit Enter. First thing I want to do is under the program key, I'm going to toggle over to input output, and I'm going to scroll down to option 8, which is clear the home screen. Hit enter. If there's any other work that I've done, I want that to get shoved out of the way so that I do not have any of that cluttering my screen. The first thing I'm going to do, this is going to be interesting. We have two situations for a how long problem, whether that is something that's happening continuously or whether it's happening discretely, which is in even increments along the way. So program key again, under the control menu, I'm gonna toggle down until I get to menu. This is actually gonna have a menu in it. So in quotes, now I'm just gonna hit the word type, and you're gonna have to use the alpha key and scour your keyboard for that. Comma, this is going to give me the heading, like what type of problem is it? Then in quotes, I'm going to type continuous and close the quotes there, comma one, that's option one in our menu, comma, and then in quotes, discrete, close the quotes, comma two, and we'll close up that command with a closing parenthesis. Enter. Then under program, again in the control tab, I'm going to toggle down until I get to label, LBL, option 9, and I'm going to hit 1. So if I choose option 1 in my menu, it will jump to this part of the program. Then when I get there, I want to have the user input some information. So first, I went program, input, output, and then chose the input option. Now I want them to type in what is the rate, R-A-T-E, hit alpha 0 to put a space there, and then in parentheses, I'm going to put it D-E-C because I want the user to know that that rate has to be a decimal, not a percentage. Okay, so we will close up the quotes for that, then comma, I want the calculator to store that as variable R. Enter. Program over to input output again. I'm going to choose input. I also need to know what the initial value is. INITIAL, initial, colon, space, close the quotes, comma. I want the calculator to store this as P. Enter. They have one more input. In quotes, this will be the final value or the output value after some time has gone by. Colon, space, close the quotes. And comma, we want to store this one as alpha A. All right, now we're going to actually grind out the math. In parentheses, I'm going to do the natural log of alpha A divided by alpha P, close up that logarithm, and then divide that by R. Close up all that calculation work, and we are going to store that as alpha T for time. Enter. That's all the math that goes into it. Isn't that incredible? Program input output, I'm going to choose option 3, which is display, and then not going to hit alpha. I want second and then 0 to open up the catalog. You can see it has alpha turned on. I'm going to hit the S key and then toggle up 8 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That should bring you to the round command. I'm going to hit enter. I'm going to choose alpha T. That's my answer, comma, but I want it rounded to 4 places. And then we'll close that up. Hit enter. Program. I'm going to toggle all the way down. I guess up would be faster until I get to stop. So it'll find label 1 since if I chose that from my menu at the start. It will run through this program, display my answer, and then it will stop. Hit enter again. Now it's time to do the discrete case. So we'll go program. I got to set that label 2, so if we choose the second option in our menu, it'll jump to this point in the program. Program, input, time to do our inputs again. We are again going to do rate, and again that will be as a decimal. Close the quotes, comma, save that as R, enter. Program, input, output, yet again, input, this time. We want initial. Comma, we will save that as P again. Program, input, output, we want to input our final value. That will be A. And we need one more input this time. And this one, we are going to save as times. We're going to label it as times, space, per, space, year. Because with a discrete situation, that's what this label 2 program is going to do, is it's going to incorporate like monthly or daily or weekly compounding. We're going to store that as alpha N. Enter. Our logarithm is, our math is a little bit more involved here. So in parentheses, let's do the natural log of, again, A divided by P. Close up that logarithm. Divided by another natural log. And inside this one goes 1 plus R divided by N, taking that rate and dividing it up N times per year. Okay, we're going to close up that logarithm, close up all of that math, and then divide that by N. And we're going to store that result as T. Enter. Then we want program input output display. And we're going to again open up our catalog. Whoops. Alpha. We're going to hit S. To jump to that point, go up 8, scroll up 8 selections. There's the round feature again. We are going to again choose T, comma, and again, we want that rounded to 4 decimal places. Now, I'm just noticing that as I was typing this out, I forgot to do like the colon and stuff like that. If you're finicky about your formatting, you could always do that. I also noticed I just went back and changed this. I had to put the ending quotes in there. I'd get a syntax error if I didn't have that before that comma N in this line. So I apologize for that. Please catch that if you're following along with me. Please make that change as well. All right, that is our program. We just have to tell, again, after this, we need to tell it to stop. So program, and then under the control menu, I'll toggle up. It's faster to get to the stop command that way. And that's it. We can go second quit. And our program should be completely working now. I do have a couple of practice problems that we can try. I'm just going to grab my worksheet here that has a key on it. So the problem that I'm going to do now says an account earns 3.25% interest compounded monthly. Find the time it takes for the account to reach $500 if $475 was invested initially. So again, it's how long. It's an account that's got compound interest. I know it's an exponential function that's driving this. Let's open up and execute that how long exp program. So when I run it, it says, what's the type? Is it continuous or is it discrete? Since they said the word monthly, I know it is discrete. So I'll go down to option 2 and hit enter. It asks me for the rate. That is 3.25%, but I need to enter that as a decimal, so I'm going to do 0.0325. Enter. The initial value is $475. Oh, see, I really want the colon in that space. I'll go back in and show you how to insert those into our program. This looks kind of sloppy. And the final value is $500. And the times per year, since it says compounded monthly, that's 12 times per year. Now, when I hit enter, it should show the answer. The answer here is 1.58 years. So if I hit enter, there's 1.5804. So it rounded to a few extra decimal places. That's okay here. But yeah, according to my key, that is the correct answer. So hopefully you got that result as well. Before we try our second example, let's go fix this formatting, because I really don't like how messy that is. So we're going to clear that screen. Let's go program, edit, our how long exp. And I'm going to toggle down to that discrete case, which was label 2. And here with my inputs, it says rate as a decimal. Then I just put the quotes right away. I'm going to move the cursor till it's over those quotations. And then second delete, see how it says INS? That stands for insert. So now when I type something in, it will insert it in front of what I have selected. So I can do alpha decimal point to get the colon, and then alpha 0 to put the space there. I'm going to toggle down and do that for my other inputs as well. So here, this one that says initial, I'm going to insert a colon and a space. Do the same thing for final. I'm going to insert colon space, and then times per year, insert colon space. Now, was that absolutely necessary? No, the program actually worked just fine, but the formatting is kind of nice to have that too. So that's all saved. Let's quit to our home screen and let's try the continuous example. All right. So this problem, an account earns 7% compounded interest compounded continuously. Find the time it takes to reach $1,000 if $750 was invested initially. So program, let's execute how long exp. I want a continuous case, so option 1 is selected. I'm going to hit enter to choose that one. The rate as a decimal, ooh, it looks like I forgot to put colon space in there as well. 7%, that's 0.07 as a decimal. The initial value, here you can see what that formatting looks like, so much nicer. Initial value was $750. I wanted a final value of $1,000. And when I hit enter, it should tell me 4.11 years. Let's see. 4.10, which rounds up to 4.11. So this program is working just fine in both the continuous and the discrete types of problems. Let's really quickly, because it's going to bug me if I don't do this perfectly. Let's go back into our program and edit how long exp. And here, right here where it says input rate decimal, see how I put the quotes right after it? I really want that colon space there. So I'm going to insert colon space. So then all my inputs have that. It's just a cleaner look when it comes out, a little bit less muddled and confusing. But that does it. We've tested our program. It works just fine. Now we have a nice way of checking that our decimal answers that we're getting for these how long questions that deal with exponential functions, compound interest, continuously growing populations and things like that, rates of decay for like, half-life problems, things like that. It'll handle all of those because they deal with exponential functions. I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope this is helpful for you. I have to restate that claim from the start of the video, though, where I say kind of boringly, I apologize for that, but I mean it from the bottom of my heart. You are not replacing education with this computer program. This is just a nice way to check and hopefully a nice exercise on how, when we do the same procedure over and over again with different numbers, a program is a nice way to provide a really quick check to problems of that sort. Thanks for tuning in and watching this video. I sure appreciate it. Have fun using it, and good luck.